There's a sense of cautious optimism among some students and families about potentially going back to class on Monday. Our Aaron Hassanzada checked in on how people are feeling as it appears the strike could come to a close.
Here, just across from Bancroft Elementary, the signs are down and the music is turned up. For now,
it is celebratory.
V. Paul Vertusio is a second grade parent and the PTO president.
I mean, our kids are so resilient. It blows my mind how resilient they are.
He says this parking lot has been a place for community to connect parents, students, and educators.
In times of crisis, our community comes together.
It's really just been kind of like this patchwork of people in the neighborhood, friends, and other parents.
MPS parent Daisy Fontaine has tapped into her community to help care for her son, Nico.
I clean houses, and then I also work evenings at a neighborhood restaurant. It's not ideal for me to bring my son to work with me. It takes me longer to do my job. He's unhappy, hungry, bored. I've learned how to ask people for help, which is something I didn't know.
I've just been waiting for the adults to come to a agreement.
North Community High School student Asaya Bankhead hopes their school Monday.
I'm most excited to see my advisory teacher, Mr. Lindquist, because I love him a lot and I miss bugging him.
I can't wait to go back to school, to be honest.
Taylor Butler is ready too.
Everybody needs to escape from something. And for a lot of kids, school is that escape for them.
And regardless of when that return happens, there were lessons learned along the way.
I feel like what we learned is that teachers are really, really important.
These teachers really care about our children.
We're celebrating that we've done all this stuff, that we survived 3 weeks. We're celebrating that we might be back, but let's just also be mindful that a vote still has to happen.
In Minneapolis, Aaron Hassanzada, WCCO 4 News.
Daisy tells us that she's still planning childcare for next week. She hopes that her son will be back in school, but just doesn't know if that's realistic. Keep watching WCCO News on TV and streaming as we continue following this story.
Law enforcement in Anoka County.